Well, the difficulty arises on a couple levels. The first is that it's in your brain. So all of the space that it occupies is a really critical part of your body. It's not like some other organ in your body where you can remove parts of it without any real implications. But then beyond that, as a cancer, it's known as the deadliest cancer in humans because it has such an ability to adjust and accommodate to any treatments we throw at it. Its ability to mutate, its ability to change its sort of genetics and constantly reinvent itself makes it very, very difficult to cure. And I would defer to Dr. Mehta, who's the deputy director of the Ivy Center and a molecular neuro-oncologist, to speak a little bit more about that.
So I think the biggest challenges in terms of treating glioblastoma is also the drugs that don't get through the blood-brain barrier. Most of the drugs that work for other cancers don't work for brain tumors because those drugs don't really get to the tumor. The second thing is, again, the complex nature of the tumors that Dr. Sanai just alluded to, that the animal studies give us some information and then those drugs move forward, but when it comes to treating humans, we don't see the same response because, again, the complex nature of these diseases. And lastly, it's a relatively rare tumor compared to the other aggressive tumors. So getting the industry involved aggressively is also difficult, a challenge.